as backward as it seems, Jesus wants to serve you. This is John chapter 13 at verse 8. Peter said to him, "You shall never wash my feet." And Jesus answered him, "If I do not wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not only my feet, but also my hands and my head." Peter's resistance to the servanthood of Jesus is, of course, understandable. Imagine letting Jesus mop your floor or dust the cobwebs in the corner while you watch. Foot washing was considered so menial that it was reserved for the lowliest servant in the house. If there were slaves in the home, the lowest ranking slave did the foot washing. Jewish slaves were not even allowed to wash feet. In fact, there were only three acceptable contexts for foot washing. One, a Gentile slave washing guests for the feet of guests. Two, washing a rabbi's feet. Or a woman might wash her husband's feet as a sign of respect and honor. No wonder Peter was appalled. He wasn't a slave. And Peter thought Jesus couldn't be like a spouse so close, so intimate. So he resisted. And why do we resist the Lord of glory washing our feet? It all seems so backwards. He's so wonderful and we feel so unworthy. We just don't understand perfect love. Grace isn't fair. And our instincts tell us life must be fair. So we, like Peter, must make a move that defies logic. We must let ourselves be served by Jesus. When Jesus says, "If I don't wash you, you have no share with me," he was using inheritance language. It's the same word the prodigal used when he demanded his share of the inheritance. Why did Peter need to let Jesus wash his feet? Because if he couldn't let Jesus wash his feet, how was Peter going to let Jesus die for him? If he couldn't let Jesus wash his feet, how would he let Jesus fill him with the Spirit and empower him to heal the sick and proclaim the Word of God? So Jesus, in all his glory, has a much greater act of service in mind for Peter than foot washing. He has in mind the cross. The Lord of glory came to do more than wash your feet. He came to die in your place. He came to wash you of your sins. So you have to let Jesus serve you. And that's the gospel. Well, that's today's good news, and to get more like it, just click right here, or better yet, please subscribe to the channel. Start your day out with good news, and I hope you have a wonderful day being served by Jesus.